F-8. F-8's forever, we used to say. The last of the gunfighters. And we really were. The F-8 was the last warbird that came equipped with 20mm cannon. It had four of those jewels. And it was a fun airplane to fly. High competition was all the F-8 squadrons on which there were many. And the highest of all honors was called the Mother Trophy. If you were the classified as qualified as the best fighter squadron in the F-8 community in a given year, you were awarded this through war fighting expertise. My squadron, the F-194, right there, we were the second winner of the Mother Trophy. There's been a lot of others besides that. But there are a lot of plaques around here. So we had a lot of pilots who scored victories over MiGs in Vietnam. However, I didn't have a chance to do it. But I did have a chance to fly the F-8 over 2,000 hours, about 2,400 hours actually. So there's a plaque here recognizing all those F-8 guys, including Joe Phaneuf, who had flown the aircraft that many hours. Also, there's another plaque over here which shows commanding officers of F-8 squadrons. And this is right here. These are the commanding officers of DFP-63. That was the next to last one. Dave Bean was the last one. And this is all the way back to 1959. Wow. So, it's nice to be recognized a couple of times here at the museum. We all flew the big bird. Bird here. This is a completely restored F-8 model. Just a pretty real full-size model. The differences between F-8 configuration-wise, this model had cannons, two on each side, carried sidewinders for air-to-air missile warfare, and also the polar bird is a different variant of the F-8 that had cameras both in the nose and no weapons. So that was a bird that went into harm's way without any way to fight back other than take a picture of it. So we've got a lot of time in the fighter version and the photo version. So when you get to the Naval Aviation Museum, and I recommend it highly because it's the most beautiful museum you'll ever see, you got to come to the home of the F-8 Crusader.